afternoon, everyone. And thank you, Mark, for the introduction. And thank you for being here with us this afternoon to attend the IRENE 99 International Trollam Day event, especially the movie, which has really touched my heart, with especially the incident that happened in 2004, the tsunami that lost so many lives. I'd like to thank President Ko, Nguyen, and the Golden Group for the invitation, and acknowledge their big effort to promote love, social harmony, and peace at a time when the world needs it most. As you got the introduction from Mark that I lead the internationalization strategy at the University of Calgary, I must confess that I was a little intrigued by the fact when I got the invitation as a professional engineer and engineering professor to talk about true love. Then I learned that, and when I read about the event, and especially looking at the humanistic celebration of continued love of life, work, and family and friends, I thought I could add some sort of thoughts to you. Take a moment to think about this simple yet powerful idea: to love your life, your work, and the people around you every day. Isn't that what could be our life's meaning and happiness and inner peace as we all seek as individuals? Wouldn't we as a society be much happier putting family love, social harmony, and particularly world peace first before our group, institution, country, or region's interest? I believe that education and universities have an important role in helping people across countries come together, understand each other's values, cultures, aspirations, and work better together to ultimately spread peace and love in the world. Universities have to be internationally focused, disseminate cultural understanding and knowledge, promote student and staff mobility, international education and research collaborations, and of course, international development, particularly in low and middle income countries. Such activities help us better understand each other, leverage knowledge and resources across the world, which leads to better working together, which ultimately promote peace, collaboration, and love. Located in North America's most livable city and fourth best city in the world, the University of Calgary from Alberta, Canada, is poised to become a global intellectual hub and help solve important societal challenges through international research and education collaborations. We currently have clinical projects in Africa, Asia, and the Caribbean, health sciences projects in Africa and Latin America, which contributes to saving lives and building capacity in these countries, and our unique education and research opportunities for our students and family, which benefits the communities. We strive to enable meaningful international collaborations, whether it is about improving maternal, child, and newborn health in Uganda and Tanzania, supporting Mexico energy reforms through our world-class energy expertise, or recruiting and supporting Chinese students to study and obtain dual degrees in their home Chinese university and the University of Calgary within 4 to 5 years. 11% of our student population is international, and we have about 1,100 plus students study abroad every year in one of the 40 plus countries. 21% of our international students are from China. We have close to 100 partnerships with Chinese universities and institutions. I take this opportunity to thank again the Golden Group for their commitment to our Birkland School of Education at the University of Calgary. With a generous gift from Mr. Cole and the group, researchers from the University of Calgary, Birkland School of Education collaborated with researchers from Harvard University. We have, of course, led by our Zuja, professor from our university, on China Youth Mental Health and Wellbeing Research Project. Within this group, it studies child development, education, and parenting from a global perspective. Because I'm from Canada, I'm proud to talk about my country, where people from all over the world live, work and play together, where we learn to be tolerant, caring, and respect each other's differences. I'd like to finish by saying this: while knowledge, science, and technology makes our lives easier, it's love, compassion, and humanity that makes us truly happy and will help our civilization go forward. Lord Buddha has advised us to radiate boundless love towards the entire world. So I urge you to encounter everything and everyone with love and compassion. Be curious about the world and thirsty and to learn something new every day, as it's only love and knowledge we take with us at the end. In the Karaniya Metta Sutta, Lord Buddha's words on love and kindness, it says, whatever living beings there may be, feeble or strong, long, stout, or medium size, short, small, large, those seen or those unseen, those dwelling far or near, those who are born as well as those yet to be born, may all beings have happy minds. I wish you the same happy minds every second of your life. Thank you, everyone.